Hi, don't we all just love the sound of vintage gear and analog synths? In this video I'm going to show you how you can use the audio modulators of the Bitwig Studio to achieve a more analog and organic synth and sampler sound. My name is Mattias and let's take the tour! Okay, so let's first quickly demo this little sound. Yeah, so here I have a little sound that I created for this tutorial, and we shall first look at this sound when it's totally clean. So this is a sample, it's a dirt bass, so it's basically just a bass sound. It sounds like this. But it's a bass. Okay, so the first thing we want to do when we want to emulate analog gear is to introduce some kind of pitch drifting into our sound, because all these electronic circuits in analog gear will affect your sound in various ways. And one of the ways is the pitch drifting. So what we can do is, of course, add a random modulator. We have all these different modulators in Bitwig Studio, and one of them is this random generator. But we have a problem with the random generator. Of course, it will generate random numbers for us, but it will generate these numbers at a certain interval. And you can set that interval here. It can be hertz, kilohertz, 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 bar, second, every fourth, every eighth, etc. So if I set this to every second bar, so if we press play here, we can actually see that it's generating a random number, but it's generating a random number at certain intervals. Even if we change this to hertz, it will still be at a certain interval that it changes, that it throws the dice and generates a random number. But we don't want ordered randomness. We want more random randomness, more chaotic randomness. So if we just remove this device for a change, and we will activate this random device that I preset. So if we listen back to this little sound clip. So I have this random generator attached with modulation to the pitch, but you can see it's a very small amount. It's only 1.0. So it's a very small amount of modulation. And I also have reduced this depth. If we increase the depth, it will be more modulation. The problem here is that it's set randomness, so we have this ordered chaos. It throws a random number, then it waits a bit, then it throws a new random number. So we still have some kind of ordered chaos, but we want more chaos. Well, we could of course create another LFO like this, another random generator, sorry, and have this random generator with a bit of faster rate, and have this one control the rate of our first random generator. That gives us a little bit more randomness, but still this one is going to randomize the first one at certain intervals. So we still have some kind of unorganic chaos in there, but we want more chaos and more organic, like analog gear. So what I found is that you can use this audio rate device. And what this device does is, we can click this device and look up here. It says audio rate sidechain. It uses a sidechain audio signal directly as a modulation source. So it basically takes another signal. In this example, I've taken this really obnoxious sound. Let's listen to that in solo. And then I repeat it. But basically, you can take any type of organic ambient sound that has some slight movement in the file. And the rate of the audio from this file will be applied to this modulator. So we can use this the rate from this one as a source. So we can actually listen to this in context. I will mute this one, but it's still going to be sent to this audio rate modulator. So this is the audio rate modulator, and it has a few settings. We can choose to use only the right or left or right channel, mono or stereo signal. So I set this to mono. Then we can also choose to rectify. It basically takes the signal and makes it unipolar instead of bipolar. So you only have 0 to 1 instead of minus 1 to 1 in your oscillation. So basically, you're going to see that in the values here if I depress the rectify. And if I introduce the rectifier, you will see that we get from 0 and up to 1 here. So now it's quite exaggerated, but you can hear this is more like a chaotic randomness, not as ordered random like it was with this random generator. So I think this is a quite nice solution if you want to have like a tape wobble sound into your music. One thing to note here is that if you're not playing back the transport bar, you will not hear any effect of the audio rate modulator, because no audio is being sent into this audio rate modulator. And I can show that if I play a little snippet here. You can hear it's still this static. It's this static sample. But if I play back this, you can hear that this little ambient world call will be applied as audio rate modulator to this sampler. And then we can set the amount here. And of course, I was exaggerating this, and we need to reduce it so we have a more subtle pitch drifting. So if we press this modulator, we can see that I'm adjusting the pitch by 0.85 and the loop offset also. I'm just adding that little extra modulation to give the sound a little bit extra body and grittiness. So we can also hear more of this ambience world call sound into this other sample, like it's layered on top of this sound. If we start to open up this filter, there's a filter on the audio rate here. So what I usually do is drag this down to quite small number, like 20 hertz something, and then we also reduce this amount, so we just get a slight pitch drift. Then you can always drag down the pitch a little bit here, because we can see that most of the time this other audio signal is a little bit higher than 0. Most of the time it's on the top side, so we need to drag down the pitch a little bit here on this, so we can drag it to minus 0.1 maybe. So this is a very cool little modifier trick that you can use. You can also use it on regular other audio tracks. I actually recorded a little guitar take here and applied the same type of audio rate modulation, also from this ambience. Really weird sound, but it works. So let's take a listen how this guitar sounds with the same type of audio rate modulation. And as with the other sound, our bass sound, we need to also be very sparse with this effect. Yeah, so you can hear there, if I open up this filter, more of the original sound will be introduced into this guitar sound. So you need to keep this quite low if you want to have a more controlled, focused sound. And of course, drag down the depth to be sure to not overdo this pitch drifting. You just want it subtle. And also make sure that it fits with your other sounds in your mix. Okay, so I think this is a really great technique to achieve a more organic and analog sound in Bitwig. Please let me know in the comments what you think about this technique and if you have any questions on this video. Thanks for watching today, thanks to all the new subscribers. We just hit 4,300 subscribers, which is insane. Thank you so much. Now you can continue and watch my next video and see you in the next one. Have a nice evening. Bye.